the Love in the Afternoon Super Feud Special. Introducing the Edge of Night family. Mark Arnold, Lori Loughlin, Sharon Gabet, Irving Lee, and Ann Blood, ready for action. And the General Hospital family. Leslie Charlson, Doug Sheehan, Sharon Wyatt, Stuart Damon, and Robin Metzen. On your mark, let's start the Love in the Afternoon Super Feud Special.
Got day three in the special 2 weeks. We got all of the best daytime dramas and television, and naturally they all belong to ABC. We got General Hospital, One Life to Live, All My Children, Ryan's Hope, and The Edge of Night. And we welcome them. We're all playing for charity. You're all sensational people. So this is the first time that Edge of Night played. General Hospital have got to win today, because at the end of this week, we eliminate one of the shows. They go. But anyway, let's welcome our newcomers right here. They're Sweetie Pies, The Edge of Night. Boom! How you doing, Irving?
Oh, hello.
Welcome.
Thank you so much. Oh, how lovely.
Thank
That's
you.
Lovely, too.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Before we meet everybody, what charity will you play for?
The Veterans Hospital Radio and Television Guild.
Oh, that's marvelous. We wish you lots of luck.
Thank you.
Can I meet everybody, please?
Please. Mark Arnold, who plays Gavin Wiley.
Nice to see you.
How are you, Richard?
Lori Loughlin, who plays Jody Travers.
Hello, Lori.
Irving Lee, who plays Calvin Stoner.
Welcome, Irving. Nice to have you here.
Nice to meet you.
And Sharon Gabet, the Raven.
Okay. You know, we wish you luck.
Thank you.
These are all my friends over here, but they're very worried because they're frightened of getting knocked out of the tournament. Welcome.
Thank you, Richard.
It looks like Gentleman's Quarterly. Looks so sharp. You do. You dress very elegantly.
Thank you.
You're gorgeous.
Thank you.
Thank you. I wish I had one for you, Irving, but they cost a pretty penny, these flowers. We'll just say we're delighted to have you here.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
And Sharon,
thank
you look gorgeous.
Thank you so much. Oh,
and
ABC's
Ravens.
The one, boy.
They are indeed. Although I personally sprung for those. General Hospital, ah! What a day. All right, man.
All right.
The last time, you played for cystic fibrosis. We had a very special reason. A dear friend of Leslie and all of you, Chris, who passed away, right, with cystic fibrosis. You won $231. You know we got $5,000 today at stake.
We're going to walk away with it.
All right.
No problem.
Let's meet everybody right away.
On my right, I got Sharon Wyatt, who plays Tiffany Hill.
Hello.
Next along, my lovely estranged wife, my second wife, I call her.
Oh, really?
Leslie Charlson, who plays Dr. Monica Quartermain. And down the line, we have Robin Matson, who plays Heather Weber.
Yeah. Hey, hey, hey.
And a real good friend, the San Diego Clipper, Doug Sheehan, who plays Joe Kelly.
Well, there he goes. Okay, you know how this is. Okay. I'm so proud of you. You never came down early or anything.
Thank
marvelous.
You.
Don't be unkind.
Thank
no,
you.
Not at all.
We gotta win. We gotta get a bouquet out of this.
Exactly. I want you to win the money. You know why.
And you know where to meet me at, Matt, later.
Oh, do I want to meet you?
Hello.
Hello. Thank you. They even smell good.
Yeah, sure. Made in Japan. The Clippers here.
Well, the Chargers. The Chargers. 20 years I've been a fan of those.
They did okay.
They did.
You should be proud of them.
We're just going to do a little bit better with, you know, this tournament.
Got to do a little better here.
Hope so.
Go and play the feud. Let's go.
Let's go.
Good luck. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you are sick in bed. Yes, sir.
Hot tea.
Hot tea. 2 answers will beat that, eh?
Hot tea.
Something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you're sick in bed.
A warm comforter.
A warm as opposed to cold comforter. No, not that. Player pass.
What do you say, guys? Let's play it.
We're going to play it, McDonald.
Okay.
We're
going
to see how it works.
Come on, gang.
Okay.
Something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you're sick in bed?
Magazines and books to read.
Maggie?
That's a good one.
Yeah.
How about your portable television set?
Okay.
Oh, well,
good.
Yeah. Nice TV.
All right, that's it.
Not just another pretty face. Something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you're sick in bed.
Cold remedies or medicines?
Okay.
Well, yeah.
Medicine!
Oh,
not that.
All right.
You better loosen your hair, honey.
Watch out, Doug.
Yeah, I'll get him. I'll protect him.
Oh, my answer would be a thermometer. You know,
exactly. Thermometer.
Heart remedy.
Oh. Loosen your tie.
Yeah.
Can you repeat the question one more
time? Certainly. Something you bring into the bedroom for a day when you're sick in bed. I guess we would assume that medicine and thermometer would already be there rather than next door.
You're sick in bed. A hot water bottle.
Yes.
That's there, okay. If not, third strike. Hot water bottle. Not there. $89 for the edge of night and bring your ass one down.
What do you want it to be?
Tissues.
Tissues,
okay. If it's there, you get the $89. If not, Stuart and the gang get the money. Tissue? You got it? Four. Five. I think I'd bring in Gina Little or Bridget or Dr. Monica. We'll be back right after.
Starting today, things can be different for most women. Our thick pad protection doesn't have to be thick anymore, because Shore and Natural Maxi Shields found a way to make it thin.
They simply eliminated the bulk and replaced it with revolutionary super fibers. So now, our thick pad protection is a thin, comfortable pad. Starting today, there's a whole new way. It's Sure and Natural, the thick pad protection that isn't thick.
Jenny, look who's here.
Hi, Grandma. Ma, I'm hot.
You've got a fever. Do you have any children's aspirin? No. I use children's Tylenol now, because more pediatricians give it to their own kids.
To bring down your child's fever fast, trust children's Tylenol.
Fever's down. Well, pediatricians know what works.
Trust aspirin-free children's Tylenol, the one more pediatricians give their own children in chewables, liquid, and drops.
General Hospital, your temperature is 89. Bad news over here. Marco, Marco! People survey, top eight answers on the board. The question is, name a singer actress.
Yes, Liza Minnelli.
Pardon?
Liza Minnelli.
Liza with a Z. Oh, I can't believe she's that low on the list.
What Barbara Streisand.
Barbara. You go. Play a pass.
We're going to pass.
We're going to pass.
Well, I think this is so easy, I think they probably made an error here.
Hello.
Hello, singer, actress, star.
The only person I can think of is Susan Anton.
Okay, let's take a look. Susan Anton! No? Oh, and she made a movie about being an athlete, and she sings, so that was a good answer. Irving.
Pearl Bailey.
Ah. Pearl Bailey!
Yes.
Oh, girl.
Oh, darling, I can't believe I didn't make that.
Olivia Newton-John.
Yeah. Hey. Olivia. Oh. Hey. A singer, actress, eh?
Diana Ross.
Okay. Oh, Diana Ross. Yeah. She's there, okay? Yeah. If not, third strike. Lady sings the blues. Diana. You got it. Well done. Marco, Marco.
Bonnie Franklin.
I know, I know.
That's
right.
She's
right. She's right.
She sure did.
Well, it was a double negative for a second, but no, she does. She had a big song and a big special.
Right?
We'll take a look. Okay. If Bonnie's there, okay, and if not, third strike. Bonnie Franklin! No. Make that lead bigger if you want to. $54. 4 inches left. Singer actress.
Go ahead. Go.
Julie Andrews.
Julie Andrews. Julie's there. You get the money. If not, Ann and the family get it. Julie! Three. Star five. Nine to five, huh?
Yes.
Can't get nine, take five. Six. And Margaret. With all the money she'd made, you thought she'd have bought a last name by now. We'll be back right after this.
Welchkins? Well, if you don't believe in Welchkins, who do you think makes Welch's grape juice so delicious?
Who do you think picks these grapes all ready to burst with flavor?
Why, Welch's has so much good natural flavor, they never add artificial flavors.
Or colors.
And who do you think puts in the vitamin C for you?
Welch's is delicious.
Take it from the Welchkins. Nobody else's tastes better than Welch's.
Even with eczema, dermatitis, and allergic minor rashes, scratching can lead to infection. That's the reason for Caldecort. Cal-de-cort. With hydrocortisone to stop the itch, Caldecort quickly penetrates into skin with the maximum strength of hydrocortisone allowed without a prescription. So nothing, nothing is more effective to help keep you from scratching your itch to infection than Caldecort. Caldecort with hydrocortisone.
America, what do you want in a cheese puff?
How about more cheese?
Yeah!
More cheese!
More, more, more cheese, please! New Cheetos Snacks has more cheese to please. And more real cheese flavor makes new Cheetos cheese-flavored snacks cheesier.
Now more cheddar makes Cheetos taste better.
There's more, more, more cheese. More cheese to please.
With new Cheetos.
Well, my buddies, General Hospital, have all the money. 143, at your night, nothing. Glory. Yes, sir.
Hi.
Here we go. First team to get to 300. Whoop.
I want it.
Anything you want, dear.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Got your lucky stone in
yes,
your hand?
Yes, I have it right
okay.
there.
It's pretty. Who
Thank
gave
you.
You that?
An actress that used to be on our show.
Oh.
I've got a pearl, guys. It's okay.
Concentrate.
Good, good.
100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something for which a woman might have a special hiding place. Yes.
Jewelry?
Jewelry. One answer will be the present.
Love letters.
Love letters. Oh, yeah. Gonna play or pass?
Play.
Play.
We're gonna play.
Bye,
okay.
Okay, guys.
Yeah. Stone worked.
Yes.
Something for which a woman might have okay. a special hiding place.
How about the diary?
Yes.
Diary.
Extra money.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. All right, sir. All right.
Money. I have a feeling the Raven knows a little something.
Oh.
My darling, we're in great shape. We've got one answer left up there, and we have no strikes on us, so everything's fine.
Some you people... really think so?
Yeah, I do. I'm confident.
Oh, that's what you feel confident,
yeah.
yes.
Something? Well, that's because I don't have the pressure of asking.
Could we try food?
Food.
Of sorts,
okay.
you know.
Oh, something. Yeah. If food's there, you got it, the game goes on. Food! $43.93. Let's go. Come on. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that makes a person a bad tenant.
Yeah. Late rent.
Before you go to that audition, by the way, try and get that phrase all together. Lilla, rent's late. Okay. One answer will beat it, Robin. One answer will beat it. Something that makes a person a bad tenant.
Noise, loud noise.
Noise of the loud variety.
What are you doing?
Liked your style there.
Thank you.
You felt a little
I liked
pressure,
your inspiration.
Didn't you? You felt the pressure from the late rent and you're either very smart or very bad tenant. I'm not quite sure.
or a landlord.
Oh, yeah. I never thought of that. I just met your wife, Doc. Yeah. How long have you been married?
Well, since August, so...
She's absolutely exquisite.
She'll do in a pinch. Pinch me, pinch
me. Tell me her name.
Her name is Kate, with a C, C-A-T-E.
If you would like to see probably one of the prettiest women in America, take a close-up of Kate. Is that a face that would just make you so happy? She's gorgeous. Thank you. What makes a person a bad tenant?
Richard, I would think if I were a landlord and somebody were a bad tenant, it would be because they were destructive of the property or not maintaining it, you know.
All right.
All right, Dougie, that's got to be a...
They knocked down walls. Oh, not there. Okay, first strike, two answers left. Stuart.
I got to say, too many people in the apartment.
Good answer.
More than agreed to, you mean?
Yeah.
All right. Come on. 111 people in one room. Oh. We can breathe freely. Now, you're a landlord. What would really upset you about a tenant? What would they have to do?
I would think because they just rip the stuff up, but that wouldn't be...
Well, that's already...
Okay, how about steal the furniture? Steal the stuff. Steal things
okay.
out of there.
All right.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
All right. Steal things.
They steal things. The case of the missing apartment. Is there okay?
Oh.
If not, that's right. Steal things. No.
No.
164. Come, children. You need it to stay alive in this game. If you don't give me the right answer, they're the champs. Something that makes a person a bad tenant.
Perhaps it's what?
Give me,
let's go.
Come.
Where's the pets? Too many pets.
All right,
or...
my angel.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. They've got 9 elephants up there. We don't like it. Too many pets. If it's there, 164, the game goes on. If not, you play for $5,000. Pets. Well done. Lappe housekeeper. 257, 143. Let's go. Come on. Come on, bro.
Come on, Sharon. All right.
I just assessed you 15 yards
sorry.
For being tardy.
I'm sorry. I'll give it back.
All right.
I'm sorry for all the bad things Raven has ever done.
It's a little blatant, but you got to admire her for it. Do this for Kate. Kate's watching. This will decide it. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an occasion when people wear flowers.
Yeah. A birthday.
Birthday. Doug?
I would say a wedding.
Wedding. What are you going to do?
What is it? Come on.
You got to go for it.
Thank you.
Kate, you should be proud.
Okay.
Occasion. Listen, I can't repeat it. This is the last question. So listen, when I get to you, you have 3 seconds to answer it. An occasion when people wear flowers.
Anniversaries.
Anniversary. Oh.
Yeah. A prom.
Oh, yeah.
Prom.
The prom.
Good one. Good
one. Get back in your little world. Listen. 3 seconds.
Prom. Graduation.
Okay. If it's there, all right. If not, third strike. Graduation. You can dethrone them right now. 260. And come on. You must...
What?
Oh, we...
These are most... bashful people have a chance to win here. Need an answer.
Easter.
Give me an answer. And...
Mother's Day.
Okay. Mother's Day's there. You're the champs. If not, Stuart, you are the champ. Mother's Day! Number two! You had them both. They had them both. Yeah, okay. Stay on it. You got 143. I need, hey, two people to play for the big money. Who's going to go? Come on. You first? Mark and Lori playing for the money right after we watch this. Not that you like this one.
In 14 days, I actually got thinner with new Diet Guard 14-day diet plan. It's fabulous.
In 14 days, I got thinner because new Diet Guard 14-day diet plan is something. A combination of diet capsules and special menus work together to actually thin you down.
14 days from start to finish. Isn't it wonderful?
New Diet Guard 14-day diet plan. 14 days from start to finish.
Big news for raisin lovers.
Even more raisins in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Two bigger scoops of raisins in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Jimmy's got the news, too.
He's telling everyone he can.
Two bigger scoops of raisins
in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Two bigger scoops give Kellogg's Raisin Bran even more raisin flavor.
You can't keep good news to yourself when you're a raisin fan.
Two bigger scoops of raisins.
When you get it,
itchy red skin.
Get Corn-Aid. When you get it,
darn bug.
Get Corn-Aid. When you get it,
oh, touch of poison ivy.
Get Corn-Aid.
Cordate gently works with your body's natural defenses. It's all you need for the relief of dermatitis and other minor itches and rashes.
When you get it,
itchy eczema.
Get Cordate.
How are these heart-to-heart stars adjusting after the deaths of Natalie and Bill? Inquiring minds want to know.
I want to know.
How can watching certain TV shows double your energy? This week's National Enquirer tells you, when are some life insurance policies a waste of money? Why do millions fear computers are taking over their lives?
It's in the Enquirer.
How did jogging help Lou Grant prevent a mental breakdown? Find out in the Enquirer. Over 100 features for people with inquiring minds.
Like me.
$5,000 for the Veterans Hospital Radio and Television Guild. We wish you luck. Got your magic stone there?
Yes, I have.
Okay, 15 seconds, please.
Oh, boy.
Tell me how long a couple should be married before starting a family.
3 years.
A nursery rhyme.
Humpty Dumpty.
A Christmas dessert.
Pumpkin pie.
A kind of reunion people attend.
Class reunion.
A size of bed.
Queen size.
Okay. You did very well. How long have you been married before starting a family? You said?
I don't know.
3 years, survey said. Nursery rhyme, Humpty Dumpty. Survey. 14. This dessert, pumpkin pie. Survey said. Look at that. That reunion, people. Music class reunion, survey said. Size of bed, long live the queen. Survey said. Excellent. Very good. Up you go. Here's Marshall. Hey, Mark.
Oh, Lord, you made it easy. You made it easy for me.
All you need is 44 points for $5,000. Please remind everyone the answers Laura gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please.
Here we go.
Tell me how long a couple should be married before starting a family.
5 years.
A nursery rhyme.
Humpty.
Try again.
Pass.
A Christmas dessert.
Pumpkin pie.
All pies. Try again.
A cake.
A kind of reunion people attend.
High school. College.
All class. Oh. Try again.
Pass.
A size of bed. Come here. A size of bed.
King size.
Okay. Very good. Turn around.
Thank you. Hold on.
Mark, how can you say it's hard when that little darling Laurie got 156?
Because she doesn't leave much left for me to sing.
Exactly. She gave me the cream of the crop. How long did a couple be married before starting family? You said 5 years. Survey said 10. Number one answer is they should be married 2 years. A nursery rhyme. You passed on that. This is tough. Jack and Jill. Right after who's buried in Grant's tomb is the next easiest question. Jack and Jill was tough, Michael. Christmas dessert, you said? Cake. All pies, number one, cake. You need 34 points. Survey said? 22. Got a reunion, people attend. You passed on that. Class reunion. Similar to Watergate, you remember they all get together. Size of bed, you said? King. You need 12 points for a big smile. You're going to give me one, aren't you?
Yes, I'll get it.
And the, you'll get it. The survey said, give him a smile. Look at that.
Mrs. Wright wrote Playtex about her girdle.
I have a better half and a worse half. So I used to wear a heavy girdle with panels. Uncomfortable. Then I tried your I Can't Believe It's a Girdle girdle. That incredibly strong, amazingly light fabric, it holds and feels comfortable. I Can't Believe It's a Girdle girdle. Firm control, but lightweight and comfortable. If you have a worse half, you'll love the I Can't Believe It's a Girdle girdle from Playtex.
Hey, Cynthia, does your mouthwash work as long as Listerine?
Mine works just as long. Almost as long.
Long enough.
Use Listerine. Listerine's strong.
Works hours longer than your number two mouthwash.
And Listerine antiseptic kills the germs that can cause bad breath.
Beautiful bride.
Beautiful bridesmaid. Oh.
For clean breath that lasts hours longer, should you ever be without Listerine?
Okay, day number three. Now, General Hospital, playing for cystic fibrosis. We've played twice. They've lost twice. So far, they've won $374. But you're not out of it because Ryan's Hope, when they played, they only won at this moment $99. So you still got to watch to see how they do in the next 2 days of the week. Edge and I playing for the Veterans Hospital Radio and Television Guild, $5,518. Tomorrow, One Life to Live versus All My Children, and we'll see you here on the Feud. Bye-bye.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
This is David Hartman. Tomorrow.
This is ABC.